I'm an American. I celebrate the 4th of July, Independence Day, freedom. That's what it's all about, right? But if you look closely at Thomas Jefferson, the guy who wrote the Declaration of Independence and what he said, he spoke about a particular kind of freedom. He put that freedom together with two other things, life and the pursuit of happiness. True freedom, true liberty, is that which makes for life what help, it gives you the ability to pursue what's truly good and what truly will make you happy. Now, unfortunately, most people don't think this way when they think about freedom. They think freedom means, I can do whatever I want. I can make whatever choice I want to make based on whatever I feel at the moment, without any constraints, without anybody telling me what to do. That's called license. And license actually doesn't usually make for life, for others or for yourself. It doesn't usually make for freedom either. It actually leads to bondage. You know this. You know this for sure. I'm sure everybody listening to me has felt impulses that have been actually rather self-destructive, like eating too much, like drinking too much, okay? That leads not to freedom, but to slavery, to weakness, and sometimes to death. I've seen that. I come from a family where there's a lot of alcohol and drug addiction. It's not pretty. And it's not freedom. Okay, the freedom that we really need to cultivate and go after is the freedom that empowers us to pursue the good, to pursue life and happiness. You need power, you need strength, and to get anywhere, you need muscle. You can't walk without muscle. You're paralyzed. Spiritually, you can't pursue the good and be free without spiritual muscle. And spiritual muscle is called virtue. Virtue really comes from the word power, comes from the word virile in Latin. It means power or strength that make your character, that give you spiritual muscle so you can be free, so you can have life. So this whole thing about virtue, you know, people have been thinking about this for at least 2,800 years, going back to the earliest philosophers and to the scriptures. You find everybody agreeing across different religions that a virtuous human being who's strong and truly free has four main characteristics, four main spiritual muscles. One is the ability to make right decisions. A truly strong and free person's got to be wise. Also, that person needs to be fair. They need to be just. They also need to be self-disciplined. Without self-discipline, you're just at the whim, you know, kind of any impulse you have can lead you astray and lead you to destruction. You also need to be courageous. Otherwise, you're going to be bullied by fear. Okay, so you need to be prudent, just, temperate, and courageous. Prudence, justice, temperance, fortitude. These are four cardinal virtues, and that word means hinge, because everything hinges on them. Okay, the seven virtues got to be built together, just like all muscles should be developed together so you're a well-rounded athlete, okay? So to be a spiritual athlete, you got to work on all of these. And that's the way you build them, is through work. How do you build physical muscle? Through exercise. Without resistance, without repeated action, without repeated exercise, you're not going to build anything. So just think about it. What's wonderful about this is the first time you go out and try to run, it's like pulling teeth, it's murder. But if you keep it up, eventually it becomes natural. You love to run. You feel best when you're running, okay? That's what virtue is all about. Through repeated action, you become strong, and all these great things that everyone admires, you know, wisdom, justice, temperance, fortitude, they become second nature. They become part of you. So just actions just flow naturally. That is the goal of Catholic moral life, okay? And there's a little saying. So Ralph Waldo Emerson said something really cool that helps us understand how this all works. Sow a thought, reap an action. Sow an action, reap a habit. Sow a habit, reap a lifestyle. Sow a lifestyle, reap a destiny. Virtue is about building a lifestyle that leads to a destiny of freedom, a destiny of life. As Jesus said in John 8, when the Son makes you free, you're free indeed.